So I've been adding fittings and guns, hatches. There's a bunch of little aircraft, anti-aircraft guns that I glued onto the deck with all of their ammo boxes. There's some winches I added on both sides. Here's the larger anti-aircraft guns that I've mounted, glued onto the deck. Also in the rear of the ship, added some there. Also in the front portion of the ship, there's some more there on both sides. Up here at the front, the bow of the ship, I've added a bunch there. And at the very, very bow of the ship, in what's called the pulpit, there's a couple of guns right there. I've added life rafts. They go on both sides of the stern. Big box hatches of some sorts. Okay, on the stern of the ship I have the catapults placed where they belong. As you can see, they rest right over the tops of these life rafts. They swivel out like so. I want to figure out some way to install these without gluing them if possible. Right now they fit fine, but they're kind of loose, and I think that it would fall off too easy. I may end up gluing them in place, but I'm going to try and figure out some way to make that peg a little tighter in that hole. I don't know if that's possible. Okay, we need to get the L-sprue. We have to build all these little gizmos right here. And these right here. I already got these that have the X's on them. Those are done. And on this side, none of them are done. So let's get the L-sprue out, and we'll finish making all these little gadgets. Okay. Okay, let's glue one of these together. These have little pins on them. Line the pins up. Push it together. Touch it with a little bit of glue, like so. Put a touch more up there and put the cap on. And there we go. One of the F parts made. And now let's do the other one. Line up the pins. It just goes right together. No fitting issues whatsoever. A dab of glue. And another dab of glue here. Take the cap. Put the cap on like so. Voila. That is the last one for this step. That was F. Okay. keep these separate over here. Oops, yeah, rolling off. And we'll go to this other page. And there is a bunch of more of these little cylinder doohickeys on the same sprue, the L sprue. So I'm going to go ahead and just off camera, turn the camera off and just make these. And we'll look at them when they're done. How's that? Okay, let's do that. All right, we're working on this page here, step 16. And we're going to be adding all these little pieces down here, and they go all along here. So I'm going to go ahead and start removing pieces off the fret, the sprues. I believe it's going to be some of these. There's going to be some photo etch too to put on. So I'll cut all the plastic pieces off first and set them all right here. And on this, so I can keep them organized, and I'll just start putting them on. Let's do that. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and put these on. Of course, you have to sand a little bit on the bottom to smooth them out so that they lay down properly. So these are the M12s, and they're going to go right in that area. Two M12s go right there. One M12 is going to go right here. Next to that M12 is going to be an M9. Okay, there's an M9, and the other M9 goes right here. Yeah. Okay. Okay. So I got those pieces right there put in, and then one right here. Those are parts M12 and M9. So what helps me is to cross them out so I know that I did those. Okay. Next, I'll turn the music down for starters.
Thanks a lot for being here tonight. Let me sing for you. I'm happy to be
here. Next plastic parts are, see, there's one here, M6 and H10. There's two M6s and one H10. So we're going to find the M sprue and the H sprue. So these are little cable reels of some sort that go in along here. And so I'm just going to go ahead and glue them. This one goes right here. A little touch of glue on that. Put some more light on it. This H10 piece right here, this little guy. You gotta make sure you orient it right. There's two pins on the back and two holes right here. And it'll go in either way, but this upper portion is bigger, so that goes on the side of the ship, right like that. I think I need the tweezers for this. Let's get the tweezers attached on it. Put the tweezers on there. Okay, take a little bit of glue, just a little bit, on the pins. Okay, and then we carefully line it up with the holes and stick it on. And there we go. H10 is on. So, let's do a little summary of what we got done here on page 16, or step 16. We got the M6 done, which is a reel. We got the H10 done, which is, I don't know what that is. We got the cylinders put up. There's a M9, a couple of M12s, a 9 and an M12. And then we got another M6 reel right there. Okay. So what's left on this step is, looks like PE parts, a bunch of PE. Photo etch. So we have these little pieces right here that go on this. We have these two little pieces that look the same as these that go on this one. And then we have some couple pieces that go on the side. So these protrusions right here on this superstructure base are where the secondary gun emplacements go. This is the secondary gun emplacements are going to go right here, the 5-inch guns. They go there and there. And they also go over here and here. Okay, so we got some PE parts to find and put them on both of these. Looks like we need the E fret and the D fret. So let's find those. We'll cut those out and then we'll put them on. Okay, I'm removing the photo etch pieces. I just wanted to show you something here, the way I remove photo etch pieces like this. You know, everybody kind of has a different way of doing it, but these photo etch frets are covered with a plastic coating to protect them. And some people take this and they peel up the end here on this and they tear the entire thing off. I don't do it that way myself. I just find the piece that I need. For example, right here, this is one of the pieces I need. And I just cut the plastic from around the piece like this. Okay, then I grab the end of that. And I just remove it completely off that piece right there. That way I didn't disturb anything else. And then since it's coated on both sides, I flip it over and do the same thing here. Just carefully make sure you don't cut the photo etch itself. Grab the end and peel it right off. There you go. So now I have two of these exposed. I need these two pieces here. And to remove them, I don't use cutters or anything. I mean, I do sometimes, but I mainly try and take my X-Acto blade like this. And I find where it connects. This thing's loose. I'm trying to tighten this back up. Okay, take my X-Acto knife. And I cut it off like that. There's one. Okay, and there's my here are my pieces of photo etch that I need for this step. One goes here, the number 3 goes out here, number 14 goes there, same on this one. So I'm going to go ahead and take these and glue them into place. Okay, I've got more fittings on. These photo etch pieces, ladders. What looks like gas cylinders. Those have all been added on. There's a photo etch door. Various fittings. The Orlikan guns. Lots of vents on the deck. There's some more Orlikan guns. Still need to paint those shields. More vents. Okay, well, moving ahead. Okay, in step 12, we are told to put these baskets in place around this railing. These baskets hold flotation devices on the ship. Here's the baskets I bought, some 3D printed ones. I elected to not use the photo etch ones, so I'm going to go ahead and start placing these down here where they belong. Looks like 1, 2, 3, 4 at this point. Okay. Step 14, which I have pretty much done. They show, you know, the catapults being attached, but they also show the airplane crane, which I have finished here. But I'm going to attach that later, towards the end of the build, as it is very, very fragile. You know, it looks great and everything right there. But, yeah, I don't want to take the risk of breaking it. Okay, so let's just continue on. I believe that step 15 is done. And step 16 is also done. Step 17 is also done. Yeah. Step 18 is done. Part of step 19 is done also. But there's still a few things to attach, like some gun tubs and such. So there's a little side assembly here of two little tubs with ladders on them. Here are the pieces. The ladders and these gun tubs, they're not gun tubs, but whatever they are. The instructions, they show them right there going all the way down to these main gun tubs here. So you look at these, and you can see, it looks to me like right there, on that little pedestal, is where these pieces are going to go. The ladders on the outside. So we'll go ahead and get the glue and attach these pieces. All right. Okay, I have the gun director platforms put on. They each have a ladder around these bofors. I also now have these davits installed. All these wheels right here. I am now going to build the secondary 5-inch guns. I need to make 10 of them. There's the parts needed for one. So I have to repeat this 10 times. 10 times. Okay, so here's the deal. I'm going to be putting together all of these 5-inch guns, turrets. There are 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 of them all together. I've already built one, and I've got all the parts out here, and I started putting the barrels onto the little dowels, plastic dowels that they go on, and they in turn are going to go onto these uprights here, and then those uprights are going to glue on to the bottom of these turrets, and then there's these little bits and pieces that go on the turret, plus a few more that I haven't taken off the sprues yet. Okay, so this is what's happening next. And we'll look at it as soon as I get them together. All right. Okay, so I've made the 10 5-inch gun mounts, or turrets, as you can see here. All the plastic parts are on. Now, we have to put ladders on the sides of them. Part number 4 on the E-fret. There's a bunch of part 4. Part 4 is right there. So we'll cut all those out and we'll start gluing them onto the turrets. Okay, as far as these 5-inch gun turrets go, they're all assembled. They all have ladders on them. And all the little miscellaneous parts that belong on them are now on. All I have to do is take these things and spray them all uniform color gray. And then they'll be ready to go, attached to the ship. At some point. They're not going to get attached to the ship until later on, because there's a lot of little miscellaneous parts that got to go in this thing. And I don't want them to get damaged. So, that's where we're at now in this build. And let's just move forward. All right, that was the end of part 4. And thank you for being with me. I hope you enjoyed it. Part 5, I will be focusing on building up the main guns, the main batteries, the 16-inch guns and their turrets, and all the photo etch parts that go on them, and getting it all painted up. So that'll be next time. And until then, y'all take care of yourselves. All right, bye-bye.